Madam Director General, representatives of the laureate, excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, it's my pleasure to welcome you all to the World Press Freedom Day in Helsinki and to this award ceremony. Today we are here to celebrate the human right to freedom of expression, including press freedom, which lies at the heart of democratic societies. Everyone has the right to freedom of opinion and expression. This has been clearly and repeatedly stated, first in 1948 in the United Nations Universal Declaration of Human Rights, and after that in other international and regional human rights conventions. These are agreements which most countries have signed and ratified. Despite this, we are today witnessing a worrying decline in global press freedoms. Every year, hundreds of journalists are threatened, imprisoned, or even killed. Without these freedoms, the promotion of peaceful and inclusive societies for sustainable development, access to justice, accountable and inclusive institutions at all levels will not be possible. To help meet these goals, Finland will focus on the rights of women and the most vulnerable population groups. Too often they remain unheard, despite the opportunities provided by new technologies. We will also stress the link between high-quality education and freedom of expression, as education promotes media literacy and offers capabilities for civic participation. Ladies and gentlemen, it is a special privilege to host this event in Finland, since we are celebrating the 250th anniversary of the world's first Freedom and Press Act, passed by the Swedish Parliament, covering modern-day Finland and Sweden. Hosting this event is also an important pillar for Finland's 100th independence anniversary next year. Access to information and fundamental freedoms, your right, this year's theme, should be a central tenet of all democracies, as it is ours. I'm extremely proud that the Finnish media has for several years been rated number one in press freedom rankings. This is, in our understanding, thanks to high level of access to official records, the importance of source protection, and an effort to provide fast internet connections to all.
My dear friends, I wish to thank first and foremost His Excellency President Sauli Niinistö for Finland's outstanding leadership in defending freedom of expression and freedom of information. And of course, to thank once again the government of Finland for its partnership with UNESCO in promoting fundamental freedoms across the world. My gratitude goes also to Helsingin Sanomat Foundation, equally for its support to UNESCO and the World Press Freedom Day Prize. Allow me equally to distinguish the presence of Ms. Ana Maria Busquet de Cano, who is with us today and who has been supporting this important event. I would say that your presence, Mrs. Cano, reminds us of the stakes we are fighting for. 30 years ago, on 17 December 1986, Guillermo Cano was killed in front of the offices of El Espectador, the newspaper he edited in Bogota, Colombia. Guillermo Cano was killed because of his campaign against drug violence. He was killed also because of his commitment to freedom of expression. And we are here today to pay tribute to his legacy. We are here also to defend the rights of every journalist and media worker. We are here to stand up for the fundamental freedoms we all cherish. These freedoms face deep challenges today, and I think the discussions that were held this afternoon paid testimony to this. Weak pluralism, censorship, restrictions, and barriers. But no challenge is more tragic than a violence. The figures are staggering. On average, one journalist is killed every 5 days, while less than 6% of killings have been resolved. Many more journalists suffer intimidation and harassment. Sexual violence is increasing, especially for women journalists. This simply cannot be allowed to go on. UNESCO is leading the fight against impunity, spearheading the International Day to End Impunity for Crimes Against Journalists on 2nd November every year across the world. Only together, I believe, we can stop the violence. This is why UNESCO works so closely with judiciaries, with security and law enforcement agencies in Paraguay, Uruguay, and Chile, in Tunisia, in Cote d'Ivoire. This work is essential for human rights and for dignity. But it is vital for the success for the 2030 Agenda for Sustainable Development. This, I believe, is the message at the heart of the world's first freedom of information law that saw light 250 years ago, covering modern-day Sweden and Finland, drafted with the help of Anders Tsutenius. The same message stands at the heart of the 1991 Windhoek Declaration, and it has never been so important. Defending fundamental freedoms calls for determination. It calls for fearless advocates. And I thank Ms. Liliana Dzurovats, chair of the independent jury, and all its members for their support and commitment. Created by the UNESCO Executive Board in 1997, the UNESCO Guillermo Cano World Press Freedom Prize is designed to honor a person, organization, or institution that has made an outstanding contribution to the defense and or promotion of press freedom anywhere in the world, and especially when this has been achieved in the face of danger. Ms. Khadija Ismailova is a freelance journalist and contributor to Radio Free Europe in her home country of Azerbaijan. She has always shown tremendous bravery in her work. She has always fearlessly gone the extra mile to cover a story. She is deeply committed to press freedoms as essential to the exercise of freedom of expression and freedom of information. No matter how difficult the circumstances, Ms. Khadija Ismailova has never wavered from her commitment to human rights and fundamental freedoms. This is why the 2016 UNESCO Guillermo Cano World Press Freedom Prize is awarded to Ms. Khadija Ismailova upon recommendation of the international jury. Unfortunately, she cannot be with us in person tonight, but we are honored to welcome her mother on her behalf. We stand with her, just as we stand for the rights of every journalist and media worker across the world.
Although the prize can only be awarded to a single person or organization, today we do not honor only Ms. Ismailova, who has stood up for the press freedom and surmounted the incredible challenges to doing so. Today, we honor all brave journalists who fight to keep the profession of journalism ethical and professional, and who are not afraid to take personal risks in order to do so. Over past years, our colleagues worldwide have increasingly been targets of attacks, threats, imprisonment, and heavy violence. The media is actively being sought after, with our press cards and accreditations putting a marker on our well-being and even on our lives.